Can we begin?
Okay, 等一下啊，等一下。
对，我把那个微信直播打开。好了，顾队，可以开始了。
可以开始啊。Om Jnanati Marandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda, Jaya Dvaita Chandra, Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda, Jaya Dvaita Chandra, Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda
Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda
Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda
Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda
So we're continuing to speak from the Madhya Lila on the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and we heard how he had come on his travels in South India He'd come to Udupi.
现在我们继续聆听主塔塔亚马哈法布的逍遥时光，Madhya Lila。现在我们聆听到了主塔塔亚马哈法布的南印度之旅，他来到了 Udupi。
Udupi is where the headquarters of the Madhva Acharya is.
Udupi 是Madhava Acharya 他设立的总部所在地。
So Madhavendra Puri was initiated in the line of Madhva Acharya.
Madhavendra Puri 他是在 Madhava Acharya 的这个传记当中接受了启迪。
And Lord Chaitanya also took initiation because he wanted to be in the same line with Madhva Acharya, with Madhavendra Puri.
这个主塔塔亚也在同一条使徒传记当中接受了启迪，因为呢，他想进入，和 Madhavendra Puri 一样的这个使徒传记。
So, Lord Chaitanya came to Udupi. He was traveling around South India, and he came to Udupi, and he saw the beautiful dancing Gopal deity, deity of Lord Krishna, as a cowherd boy dancing.
所以呢，这个主塔塔亚马哈帕布就在南印度旅行的时候，他来到了乌都比这个地方。在乌都比这个地方呢，有一个 Krishna 的这个木牛童的神像，叫勾跳舞的勾帕神像。
So we had at first the people in the temple at Udupi, they thought Lord Chaitanya was a Mayavadi sannyasi.
我们之前听到了，在乌都比的这个庙宇里面的这些，这些这个祭司，刚开始以为主财坦亚马哈法布是 Mayavadi sannyasi.
Does anybody remember how what's the difference between the Mayavadi sannyasi and the Vaishnava sannyasi?
大家还有人记得 Mayavadi sannyasi 和 Vaishnava sannyasi 之间的区别吗？
还记得，对，Mayavadi sannyasi 是一个单把棍儿 ，sannyasi 棍儿，那个 Vaishnava sannyasi 是三节的，还有Vaishnava sannyasi 有西卡，然后那个 Mayavadi 的那个没有西卡。我先说两个吧，别人再说其他的。Hare Krishna。
Okay， 还有一个，还有，Who knows？ 还谁知道？还有一个。
Vaishnava sannyasi 会佩戴圣戒，
yeah.
而那个 Mayavadi sannyasi 不会佩戴圣戒。
Right, when they become sannyasi, they take off their Brahmin thread and they cut off the sikha.
这个 Vaishnava sannyasi 他们在接受启迪的时候，他们会佩戴这个圣线，并且他们会留这个西卡。
So how did they know Lord Chaitanya was a Vaishnava?
那他们又怎么知道主财坦鸟是一位 Vaishnava 的呢？
Hare Krishna， 你说。
Hare Krishna， 因为他们看到那个主持人呀，又唱又跳，然后他们就知道他是这个，不是坐在那儿冥想，然后他就是知道他是来自达瓦奉献者。Hare Krishna。
Yes, they saw that he had so much love for Krishna. He was ecstatic. The ecstasy, the love, the emotion which he had. That this is the difference between the Mayavadi and the Vaishnava.
因为呢，他们看到了主财坦雅对 Krishna 有如此多的爱，这个主财坦雅他处在这个狂喜当中，所以这是Mayavadi sannyasi 和 Vaishnava sannyasi， Mayavadi 和 Vaishnava 之间的区别。
The Mayavadis, for the Mayavadi, everything is very dry, very dry. They don't have any bliss. They don't experience any ecstasy.
那些 Mayavadi 的那些人士呢？他们都是非常枯燥的，他们没有任何的这种喜悦，没有极乐。
So when they saw Lord Chaitanya's mood, they could understand that, oh, he is a Vaishnava.
So when they saw the Lord Chaitanya's mood,
So Lord Chaitanya spoke with the head of the temple there, and he asked the head, the main devotee there, the one in charge, who was a scholar, he asked him, he said, I want to know what is the aim of life and how to achieve it.
然后呢，这个主财坦雅马哈法布就对这个庙宇里的这个首席的祭司说道，这个首席的祭司呢是一位学者，马哈法布就对他说呢，我不知道生命的目标以及如何达到它。
So he said, you have to follow the varna and ashram. And you have to do all, dedicate all your activities for Krishna by following the Varna and Ashram.
所以这个首席祭司就回答呢，你要遵守这个 Varna Ashram 的制度，你要把你在 Varna Ashram 当中的活动都献给 Krishna。
And then you that way you become qualified for liberation.
这样的话呢，你就有资格获得解脱。
This is the he said. This is the goal of life.
他说这就是生命的目标。
But Lord Chaitanya didn't agree. He said, "Well, I see in the Shastra that the process of hearing and chanting is the most important to get the goal of life."
但是主禅台亚马哈帕布并不同意他的说法。他说呢，根据这个沙索经典而言呢，聆听和唱诵才是获得生命最高目标的方法。
Lord Chaitanya knew that the Madhvacharya followers, that they are all devotees of Krishna, they worship Krishna. So he could talk to them about devotional service.
主禅台亚知道这些 Madhvacharya 的追随者们呢，都是奉献者，所以呢，他们都知道 Krishna， 所以他可以向他们教导这个对 Krishna 的这个奉献服务。
So Lord Chaitanya told them how in the scriptures it talks about the nine forms of devotional service, and this is how you get the goal of life.
所以主禅台亚就向他们描述了这个九项奉献服务，他就说到呢，这个奉献服务。才是达到这个获得生命目标的方法，最好的方法。
And when we do the hearing and chanting properly, then we will also begin to feel ecstasy. We will get transformations within the body as we awaken love for Krishna.
当我们从事这个聆听和唱诵等奉献服务的时候，我们也会感受到这个极乐之情。随着我们的对 Krishna 的爱的这种唤醒，我们的身体也会发生这种转变。
And somebody who is actually advanced, they will take pleasure in chanting the holy name of the Lord.
一个真正进步的人会从唱诵主的圣名当中获得快乐。
So Lord Chaitanya didn't accept what these Madhvacharya followers were saying.
所以主禅台亚马哈帕布并不赞同这些 Madhvacharya 的追随者所说的。
Their interest was just to get some fruitive benefit and then to get liberation.
因为他们只是想得到一些祝福，想得到一些解脱。
They don't get love of God that way.
他们通过那种方式并不能获得对神的爱。
But Lord Chaitanya says the goal of life is to develop love of God.
但是主台坦雅却说这个生命的最高目标是获得对神的爱。
So Lord Chaitanya quoted the verse from the 18th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita where Krishna says, give up all varieties of religion and just surrender to me.
对主禅台亚马哈帕布，他就引出了《国家梵歌》第十八章当中的诗节，主贝什纳说到：“放弃所有的宗教原则，只是皈依于我。”
But if we're still interested in some material results, if we still want to enjoy something in the material world, then it will be very difficult for us to have a taste for devotional service.
如果一个人还对这个物质世界的这个果报性活动感兴趣的话，他就很难从奉献服务当中获得品味。
We have in that case, you have to follow the regulative principles of the Vedas.
在这种情况下呢，一个人就应该遵守韦达经所提出的规范原则。
And devotees are not very eager to get liberation. It's not important for a devotee.
然而奉献者并不渴求获得解脱，解脱对奉献者而言是并不重要的。
Unless there's an opportunity, if the devotee can only accept liberation if there's an opportunity for devotional service to Krishna.
只有当这个存在着机会能够去为 Krishna 做奉献服务的时候 ，Krishna 奉献者们才会接受解脱。
But without devotional service, then it's just hellish for a devotee.
但是如果没有奉献服务的话，那这对奉献者而言就像是地狱一般的处境。
A devotee is not afraid to go to hell. He'll go to hell if there's devotional service.
奉献者们甚至不害怕去地狱。如果那里有奉献服务的话，奉献者甚至会去到地狱。
He doesn't see any difference between heaven and hell and liberation because everywhere he goes, there's devotional service.
奉献者们并不区分是天堂还是地狱还是解脱，因为奉献者们无论去到哪里，他们只是从事奉献服务。
But the Madhva people, they were saying the goal is to get liberation. The goal, they were saying that's the goal of life.
然而这些 Madhva 派的追求者们呢，他们说解脱是生命的最高目标。
But Lord,
他们说，
But Lord Chaitanya said, the goal of life is to develop love of Krishna.
但是主查坦雅说，生命的最高目标是发展对 Krishna 的爱。
So the idea of liberation or material gain that is not in the thinking, that's not important for a devotee.
对这种解脱还有获得物质利益的想法，对于奉献者来说并不重要。
But you're making these things the goal of life in your teaching, your preaching.
然后呢，你们在你们的这个教导当中呢，却宣称这个解脱是最高的目标。
So Lord Chaitanya was not satisfied in coming to their ashram and hearing from them. He was very disappointed.
所以呢，主查坦雅来到他们的庙宇，聆听他们的讲话呢，他并不感到满足，他感到很失望。
And these Madhvacharya people, they were amazed to hear Lord Chaitanya. They saw how much strong faith he had in the teaching of Vaishnavism.
对，当这些 Madhvacharya 的这些追随者们听到主查坦雅马哈法布所说的话的时候呢，他们感到。非常的惊讶，他看到这个马哈法布对外斯拉玛法中有如此强烈的信心。
And they told Lord Chaitanya that we know what you're saying. This is actually the real teaching of the scriptures.
他们对马哈法布说道：“您所说的一切都是事实。这是所有启示经典的结论。”
But we are just following what has been the custom here within our ashram. This is the standard. This is what we preach.
但是呢，我们所说的这些呢，是我们的庙宇的这个标准。我们只是按照我们的这个标准来做的。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "Well, both desire for karma and desire for jnana." Are not part of devotional, pure devotional service.
主查泰马法布说到呢，对这个果报性活动和哲学思辨的这种渴望，都不属于奉献服务当中的一部分。
But I see both these things in your teachings, in your ashram, in your preaching.
但我在你们的这个教导当中。看到了这两种成分。
And then Lord Chaitanya said, "The only good thing I see in your sampradaya is that you accept the form of Krishna as the truth."
主查坦雅继续说道：“我在你们的这个三帕拉雅中看到的唯一的资格是你们接受主的形体为真理。”
Yeah.They worship the deity as Krishna himself. They don't just think it's just a statue. They actually know that the deity is Krishna.
因为他们崇拜这个神像，把这个神像作为 Krishna 本人去崇拜。他们并不认为这个神像只是一个雕塑。他们接受这个神像为 Krishna。
So that's why Lord Chaitanya took, that's another reason why Lord Chaitanya took initiation in that sampradaya.
所以这是主坦坦雅在这个使徒传系当中这个桑帕达雅当中接受启迷的另一个原因。And
it was actually Madhavendra Puri who brought the real life into the sampradaya.
实际上是 Madhavendra Puri 把真正的生命带入了这一条使徒传系，这一条桑帕达雅当中。
And he taught also about the position of Srimati Radharani. And he showed by his example how to feel separation from Krishna and the mood of the gopis.
他亲身的释放了，就是释放了这个。 与 Krishna 的这种分离之情，也就是木流姑娘们的心态。
So Madhavendra Puri, he greatly improved the standard within the Madhvacharya Sampradaya.
所以 Madhavendra Puri 将这个 Madhvacharya 的这个传系的这个标准呢，提高了很大的程度。
And Mayavadis, the Mayavadis, they worship the deity. They may have statue of Krishna, but they think that the statue of Krishna is just material. They don't think of it as being spiritual.
Mayavadi 呢，他们也可能会崇拜这个神像，但是呢，他们只是认为这个只不过是一个雕塑，是物质的，他们并不认为这个神像是灵性的。
You will see. When you go to a Mayavadi temple, you see how they worship. They do worship on a very low standard.
如果你去这个Mayavadi的他们的庙宇的话，你会看到他们是如何崇拜神像的。他们这个崇拜的标准非常的低。And
their worship and their motive is that one day we will give up the worship, because one day we will become Krishna or we will merge with Krishna.
而他们崇拜的时候的这种心态呢，就是说，终有一天他们会放弃这个崇拜，然后呢，他们会变成 Krishna， 与 Krishna 合一。So
Madhavendra Puri, he took initiation in the sampradaya also because they accepted the transcendental form of Krishna.
Madhavendra Puri 之所以在他们的这一条这个桑帕达雅中接受启迪的一个原因，就是他们接受 Krishna 的超然的形体。So
in this way, Lord Chaitanya instructed the followers of Madhvacharya in the actual process of devotional service.
所以就像这样，主查坦尼亚马哈帕布就教导了这些 Madhvacharya 的追随者们。
Lord Chaitanya actually took two principles from the Madhvacharya Sampradaya, which he incorporated in his own Sampradaya.
实际上，这个主查坦亚马哈布从Madhvacharya的这个Sampradaya当中吸收了两条原则，并且。 纳入到了他自己的这个Sampradaya当中。
Yeah, Lord Chaitanya Sampradaya comes from Madhva, then it becomes Gaudiya. When we accept Lord Chaitanya, then it becomes Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya.
这个普查坦亚马哈帕布的这一条使徒传记呢，叫做 Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. 当我们提到普查坦亚马哈帕布的时候， 我们说的是这个使徒传系。Yeah,
we are known as the Gaudiya Sampradaya.
我们被称为Gaudiya Sampradaya.
And that means that we follow Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings.
也就意味着我们追随主查坦亚马哈帕布的教导。So
from the Madhva Sampradaya, Lord Chaitanya took the principle about defeating Mayavadi philosophy. And also, accepting the form of the deity is transcendental.
所以这个主查塔亚呢，从曼达瓦塔亚的这个沙瓦塔亚当中，吸收了两条原则，其中一条呢是击败玛雅瓦底哲学，第二个呢是接受主奎什纳超然的形体。
Okay, so Lord Chaitanya then leaves Udupi and he goes to visit many different places, different temples.
然后呢，这个主禅量马法布就离开了 Udupi， 然后他去到了很多不同的地方，去了很多不同的庙宇。
He would go to see temples of Shiva, and temples of Hanuman, temple. He would go to see all the different temples.
他会去看这个西瓦的庙宇，还有哈努曼的庙宇，就是他会去很多的庙宇。
And everywhere he would chant and dance, and chant the holy name of Krishna and dance, and tell people to chant Krishna's name.
无论他去哪里呢，他都会唱诵主的圣名，并且跳舞，而且他会教导每一个人唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。
So, Lord Chaitanya is chanting and dancing, takes him all the way back. He comes back to the place where Ramananda Rai was staying, and he meets Ramananda Rai again.
所以就像这样呢，主禅那马法布一路唱着跳着，又返回到了 Ramananda Rai 所在的地方。
And he's happy, very happy to be with Ramananda Rai again.
他非常高兴再次见到 Ramananda Roy.
And he tells Ramananda Roy everything about his traveling, and he gives them also the books which he brought back.
他就向 Ramananda Roy 讲述了他在这个旅行当中所发生的这些事迹，并且呢把他拿回来的这个书给了 Ramananda Roy.
Yeah, the two books. Who knows the name? What was the name of the two books Ramananda Rai found, Lord Chaitanya brought? When he was traveling in South India, he found two books, very important books, and he brought them to give to the devotees at Jagannath Puri.
所以主查塔亚马法布在他的南印度之旅的过程当中，他得到了两本很重要的书籍。然后呢，他把这个两本书籍交给了 Jagannath Puri 的奉献者。大家谁知道这两本书籍是哪两本呢？
有一本是 Brahma Samhita， Samhita，
Samhita， yeah， Samhita， Brahma Samhita， that's yes， he got that from the Adi Keshava temple way down in South India， the bottom of South India。
这个其中的一本是 Brahma Samhita， 他是在 Adi Keshava 庙就得到这部书的。
And then he got another book called the Krishna Karanamrita。
然后他还得到了另外一本书，叫做 Krishna Karanamrita。
This book was written by a devotee called Bilva Mangal Thakur。
这本书是一位名叫 Bilva Mangal Thakur 的奉献者所著的。
Bilva Mangal, he was a Mayavadi before becoming a devotee.
Bilva Mangal, 他在成为奉献者之前是一位 Mayavadi.
So it's a very important book.
这是一本非常重要的书籍。
And Lord Chaitanya brought these books with him back, and he showed them to Ramananda Rai. Ramananda Rai made copies for himself.
所以主禅量马跑步呢就把这本书给带了回来，然后展示给 Ramananda Rai 看。Ramananda Rai 呢就给他自己复印了一本。
And Lord Chaitanya was.Telling Ramananda Rai, he said, "Everything you've taught me, everything I heard from you about Krishna, is all confirmed by the teaching in this book, Brahma Samhita."
主查那亚马哈帕布就对拉姆兰纳瑞说道呢，你给予我的所有的这些教导都得到了这部经典 Brahma Samhita 的证实。
So Ramananda Rai is very happy also to get these books.
Ramananda Rai 得到这些书籍的时候也感到非常的高兴。
So then Lord Chaitanya tells Ramananda Rai, Ramananda Rai tells Lord Chaitanya first of all, he said, I wrote to the king and I told the king I want to give up my job.And the king said, no problem. He said, the king welcomes me to come back and stay in Jagannath Puri.
这个 Ramananda Roy 就对主查那亚马哈帕布说到呢，就说他已经跟这个国王已经说过了，就是说他要放弃这个王这个职位，然后他要去到 Jagannath Puri.
And the king has promised that he will maintain me, even though I'm not working.
而且这个国王呢，他已经答应我会维系我，即便是我不继续再从事这个职务。
So Lord Chaitanya tells Ramananda Roy, let's go together. We can go together to Jagannath Puri.
所以主查那亚马哈帕布就对 Ramananda Roy 说到呢，我们可以一起，去 Jagannath Puri。
But Ramananda Rai said, whoa, he said, no, just a minute. He said, if I go with you, he said, when I go, he said, there will be so many people coming with me. There will be elephants and horses. There will be a lot of noise. He said, I don't think it would be very good for you to come with me.
但是 Ramananda Rai 却说呢，如果你和我一起旅行的话，那将会有很多的这个马、大象还有士兵。他们都会发出这个喧嚣声，所以我并不觉得你和我一起旅行对你是好的。
So Ramananda Rai said, "You go first, and I'm coming within 10 days. I will come there."
所以 Ramananda Rai 就说呢，您先去Puri， 然后我会在10天之内做出安排。
And so in this way, Lord Chaitanya left, and he went back.He came up all the way up to Alanath, where he had passed through, and when he was coming to South India, the first stop after Jagannath Puri was Alanath. So Lord Chaitanya came to Alanath.
所以然后呢，这个主呢就原路返回，一直来到了这个 Alanath。他在离开这个加格纳布瑞前去南印度旅行的时候，就是经过阿拉纳的这个地方。
And then when they got to Alanath, Lord Chaitanya sent his servant Krishna Das. He told Krishna Das, "You go to Puri and tell the devotees that I'm here, and they can come and meet me."
然后这个当主查那亚马哈帕布来到阿那那的这个地方的时候呢，他就派他的仆人 Krishna Das 前去 Puri， 通知那些奉献者们，就告诉那些奉献者们，我已经到这里了。
So Krishna Das went to Puri and he told, and immediately Lord Nityananda came rushing to Alanath. He's so happy to see Lord Chaitanya again.
所以这个 Krishna Das 呢，他就跑到了这个 Puri 去通知奉献者们。当 Nityananda 阿布听说这个消息的时候呢，他就立刻跑向了这个 Anana 这个地方。他很高兴再次见到主查那亚马哈帕布。
And Lord Nityananda came, other devotees also came with him. Makunda came, Jagadananda came. They were so happy. And Sarvabhoma also came. They are all eager to see Lord Chaitanya again.
所以当尼加纳那帕布去到那里的时候呢，其他的奉献者也跟着他一起去了那里，包括穆昆达、这个达南达，他们都很高兴能够见到主。这个萨瓦巴玛巴塔查亚也去了，他也很高兴再次见到主。
They were all dancing and chanting. They were in ecstasy to see the Lord again.
他们都在快乐地跳舞唱诵，所有的人都很高兴再次见到主。
Sarvabhoma Bhattacharya brought everyone to his home and He arranged Mahaprasadam from Jagannath for Lord Chaitanya and everybody. They had a big feast.
这个沙瓦巴玛巴塔查亚呢，就把所有的人都带到了他的家中，并且呢，他安排了这个主加格纳的玛哈普沙达，给予主坦赞玛法布和奉献者们，然后大家都饱餐了一顿。
And Lord Chaitanya stayed awake the whole night talking about his travels in South India and the different places he went.
坦赞玛哈布呢，就彻夜的，没有睡觉，在那儿向大家讲述，他在南印度的旅行。
And Lord Sarvabhauma had Lord Chaitanya stay at his home for a few days.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢，就把坦赞玛哈布留在家中，过了几天。
Of course, they had to.When they came back, the first thing they did, they had to go to see Lord Jagannath and have darshan of Lord Jagannath.
当然了，当主这个回来的时候，他们所做的第一件事情就是去看主加格纳。
And they gave Lord Chaitanya garland from Lord Jagannath, and they gave him some prasadam of Jagannath.
然后这个祭司呢，就把这个主加格纳的这个祭鱼还有花环给予了主查坦尼亚。
So Lord Chaitanya was in ecstasy to see Lord Jagannath again.
主查坦尼亚看到主加格纳的时候呢，他感到非常的高兴。
So this way, this is how.We hear about Lord Chaitanya traveling in South India.
这就是我们聆听到了这个主塔坦雅是如何在南印度旅行的这个逍遥时光。
So now they're ready for the next chapter. We will hear about Lord Chaitanya, how different devotees all come to join him in Jagannath Puri.
在下一章当中，我们将聆听到奉献者们是如何来到 Jagannath Puri， 加入到主坦赞玛的。
So.When Lord Chaitanya comes back to Jagannath Puri, in Orissa, of course, in Jagannath Puri, there's the king of Puri, the Maharaj of Puri, and he's very eager to meet Lord Chaitanya.
在 Orissa 邦的这个 Jagannath Puri 呢，有一个国王，这个国王非常想见到主财坦达。
But,Lord Chaitanya doesn't like to meet kings.
但是呢，主查坦雅并不想与这些国王会面。
Because Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi, he said the business of a sannyasi is not to deal with materialistic people like kings.
因为呢，主查坦雅马卡布是一位 sannyasi。对萨尼亚西而言呢，他不应该和这些物质主义者，比如说国王这样的人，去联谊。
Anyway, the king talks to the Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is the main priest in the Puri temple, and he has to report to the king. And so the king asks him. He said, "I hear this a great personality has come from Bengal."
因为呢，这个沙巴巴玛巴塔查亚他是这个加格纳庙的这个主席祭司，所以他的有责任呢向国王汇报。所以国王就问他，这个是不是从孟加拉来了一位伟大的人物
？He's staying at your home. I heard he's staying at your home, and I heard he's very merciful.
国王对巴塔泰尔说呢，我听说这个伟大的人物已经住在你的家里，我还听说他非常非常的仁慈。
And I heard he gave you great mercy. You got a lot of mercy from him.
我也听说呢，你从这位伟大的人物那里得到了很多的仁慈。
So now you should arrange for me to get also some mercy. I want to meet him.
现在呢，请你也给我安排一次与他的会面，让我也能够得到他的仁慈。
So the Bhattacharya said, well, that's true. It's true, he's a very great soul, and I got a lot of mercy from him. But it's very difficult to arrange a meeting for you.
Bhattacharya 就回答说呢，这一切都是真的。我是从这位伟大的人物那里得到了很多的仁慈，但是呢，要安排他与你会面的话，这是很困难的。
He's very detached from material affairs.
他对世俗的事物非常的超脱。
He stays alone in very quiet places, and even in dreams, he doesn't meet with kings.
他独自住在一个僻静的地方，甚至在梦中他都不会同意接见一位国王。
Then Bhattacharya said, anyway, I could try to arrange for you to meet him, but he's already gone to South India. You're already too late because he's left for South India.
Bhattacharya 就说到呢，尽管如此，我本来打算试着安排主来接见您的，但是呢，他刚刚最近离开去南印度旅行了，现在已经太晚了，因为他已经离开去南印度了。
But the king said, why did he leave Jagannath Puri?
国王就问到呢，他为什么要离开 Jagannath Puri 呢？
And the Bhattacharya said, well, he's a great personality, I can't control him.
Bhattacharya 就回答说呢，他是一位伟大的人物，我不能控制他。
He goes wherever he wants, I can't stop him, I can't control him.
他按照他自己的意愿，去到任何地方，我是不可能控制他的。
He likes to visit the holy places. He likes to give his mercy to the souls there.
他想要去到各个这个圣地去旅行，他要把他的仁慈给予那些灵魂。
No.In Srimad Bhagavatam, there's that verse, famous verse, right? Bhavadbhida Bhagavatas Tirthaputta Swayambhivo Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Swantaste Nagadabhrita. This verse is spoken by Maharaj Yudhisthira to Vidura.
这是来自于圣典薄伽瓦坛当中的一个诗节，这个诗节是Yudhisthira Maharaja 向 Vidura 去讲述的。
Now Vidura is a sudra.
Vidura 是一名 sudra.
But he's a great soul.
但他是一位伟大的灵魂。
And Maharaj Yudhisthira says, you purify the holy places just by your presence.
尤迪士提尔就说到呢，仅仅是因为您的灵在，就净化了这些圣地。
This is one of the duties of a Vaishnava.
这是一位 Vaishnava 应该履行的职责。
Because a Vaishnava carries the Lord in his heart, so wherever he goes, he purifies that place.
因为一名 Vaishnava 将主放在他的心中，所以无论这样的一位 Vaishnava 去到哪里，他都会净化那个地方。
So the king says to the Bhattacharya, why did you allow him to leave? You should have begged him to stay.
这个国王呢就问巴塔查亚。你为什么允许他离开呢？你为什么不恳请他留下来呢？
But the Bhattacharya said, well, he's the Supreme Lord. He's Krishna himself. He can do whatever he wants. He's not dependent on me.
萨瓦巴玛巴塔查亚就回答说呢，他是智睡人和守贞本人，他是主 Krishna， 他并不依赖任何人。
He said, I tried to keep him, but I wasn't successful. I tried to get him to stay, but he wouldn't listen to me.
我非常努力的要把他留在这里，但是呢，我没有成功。
So the king said, oh, he said, so this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Krishna. You're saying he is Krishna. You must know, you're a very learned person. If you say he's Krishna, it must be true.
这个国王就说到呢，巴塔查亚，你说这个主查坦亚是主 Krishna， 因为你是最渊博、最有学识的人。所以，如果你说这个主塔坦雅是主 Krishna 的话，那么我也接受，这样的说法为真理。
So the king begs the Bhattacharya. He said, "When he comes back here, when he comes back to Puri, I just have to see him once. I just want to see him to make my eyes perfect."
这个国王呢，就对这个萨瓦巴玛巴塔恰雅说道：“等这个主查塔亚马哈帕布回到库里的时候呢，请你就哪怕安排一次，我与他会面，这样的话使我的眼睛达到完美。”
So the Bhattacharya tells the king, "Well, he's coming very soon. He'll be back very soon, and I need a place for him to stay. We have to give a nice place for him to stay, which is quiet and peaceful." No, where nobody will disturb him.
萨瓦巴玛巴塔查亚就对国王说道呢，主查塔亚马哈帕布很快就会回来，我们要给他准备一个非常好的地方，让他可以居住。这个地方呢，应该是非常的安静、寂静的，没有人去打扰他。
And wherever you put him, it should be quiet, and it should be near the temple of Jagannath, because he will like to go to temple and see Jagannath every day. So it shouldn't be too far away from the main temple.
这个地方呢，应该要非常的僻静，而且要离这个加格纳庙很近，因为呢，主查塔马法布每天要去觐见主加格纳，所以这个地方呢，不能够离加格纳庙太远。
So the king said, "Well, Kasimishra's house is, you can get a room there. It's near the temple and it's very quiet and calm."
国王就回答说呢，这个 Kasimishra 有一个房子，很好。这个房子呢，离庙很近，而且呢又很清静，非常的隐蔽。
Kasimishra is the guru of the king.
Kasimishra 是这位国王的侮辱。
So after this, the king was always anxious, waiting for Lord Chaitanya to come. When is he coming? When is he coming?
在这之后呢，国王就变得非常渴望主塔坦雅回来。他总是在想着主什么时候会回来，什么时候会回来。
So the Bhattacharya, he arranged Lord Chaitanya's room, and he got Kasimishra, he told Kasimishra that Lord Chaitanya is going to come and stay with you.
这个萨瓦巴玛巴塔查亚呢，就安排了这个 Kasimishra 的一个房间。他对 Kasimishra 说到呢，主塔坦雅马上就会回来住到你家里。
Kasimishra is very happy. He said, "I'm very fortunate. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Lord of all the Lords, and he's coming to stay in my home. It's my good fortune."
当 Kasimishra 听到这个提议的时候呢，他非常的高兴。他说到呢，我真是太幸运了。主查塔亚马哈帕布是所有帕布之主，而他将住在我家，我真的是太幸运了。
So in this way, everybody in Jagannath Puri was very anxiously waiting for Lord Chaitanya to come.
就这样呢，这个 Jagannath Puri 的所有的这些奉献者都非常渴望主查塔亚马哈帕布回来。
And so when they heard that he'd actually come, then they all became ecstatic.
当他们听说塔塔亚马哈布真的回来的时候呢，他们都变得非常的急了。
And the king said, "You have to arrange our meeting. I want to meet Lord Chaitanya. It's only possible by your mercy."
这个国王就说呢，请安排我们和主塔塔亚马哈布会面，只有通过您的仁慈，我们才能够得到这个主的会面。
So, the next day, Lord Chaitanya arrived and went.To Sarvabhaumabhat, went with Sarvabhaumabhattacharya first to the temple to see Lord Jagannath.
第二天呢，主查达玛法布就终于到了，他就和这个沙瓦巴玛巴塔查亚一起去加格纳庙去觐见主加格纳。
And when Lord Chaitanya came there, then all the servants of Lord Jagannath, they brought.Lord Jagannath's prasadam, and they gave it to Lord Chaitanya.
当主查塔亚马哈帕布到达那里的时候，主加格纳的所有的这些仆人就把这个加格纳的食物觊觎，拿给了主查塔亚。
So Lord Chaitanya saw the Jagannath, and then he met all the devotees and embraced them, and then they left, and they took him to the place where he's going to stay, the home of Kashi Mishra.
然后主查塔亚马哈帕布他觐见过了主加格纳神像，并且见过了所有的这些奉献者们之后呢，他就前往他居住的地方，也就是卡西米舍的家。
And Kasimishra welcomes Lord Chaitanya. He said, "I'm your servant. Everything here is for you. Just tell me anything you want. I'm happy to serve you."
这个帕西米舍就对这个主塔塔亚玛哈布说道呢，所有的这些物品都是为您准备的，这个您需要什么只要告诉我，我很高兴来服务于您。
So then all the devotees, they all sat down with Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda's with Lord Chaitanya, and all the devotees, they all crowded along Lord Chaitanya, and they're very happy to be together.
然后呢，所有的这些奉献者们就环绕着主查塔亚和他坐在一起，包括 Nityananda, 所有的这些奉献者们都很高兴再次见到主查塔亚。
If you go to Jagannath Puri, we get to go in here to the place, the home of Kasi Mishra. The deities are there of Kasi Mishra, and you can see also the room where Lord Chaitanya stayed.
如果我们去这个加纳普瑞的话，我们应该去这个 Kasi Mishra 的家。在这个 Kasi Mishra 的家里面有一尊神像，而且呢，我们也能够看到。当时主查塔亚马哈帕布所居住的那个房间
It's a Lord Chaitanya's room was very small, very very small, simple room.
主查塔亚马哈帕布居住的这个房间是非常非常小的，非常简朴的一个房间。
So they gave the room to Lord Chaitanya, and they're telling him, this is a good place, this is a room, we think this is suitable for you. Please, you say, accept it. And Lord Chaitanya said, yes, he said, it's very nice.
他们就对这个塔塔亚马哈布说到呢，这个房间呢就是为您准备的，这是一个非常好的地方，我们认为呢这个房间很适合您，请接受它。
Lord Lord Chaitanya said, "My body belongs to you, so I agree to whatever you say."
主查塔亚马哈帕布说到呢，我的躯体属于你们所有的人，无论你们说什么，我都同意。
So.The Bhattacharya, he introduces all the different people from Jagannath Puri, he introduces them to Lord Chaitanya.
接下来呢 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就把这个 Jagannath Puri 的这些奉献者们介绍给了主 Chaitanya.
He said they've all heard about you and they've been very anxious to meet you.
巴达沙亚说到呢，这些奉献者们都非常渴望见到你。
He told how the different devotees, how they serve Krishna, what service they do in the temple, how they are involved in the service of the deities.
这个巴达沙亚呢就介绍了这些奉献者们所从事的服务，就介绍了他们是如何在庙宇里从事服务的，服务成像的。
One of the devotees who was introduced was Shiki Mahiti.
他介绍的这个其中一位奉献者名字叫 Shiki Mahiti.
Yeah. So his duty, his job is writing, and he has to write everything for the service of the deity. He has to write the calendar and do all these kind of things.
这个名叫 Shiki Mahiti 的这位奉献者呢，是专门负责写作的。他就会写这些日历，就是要用来为神像服务的。所有的这些写作就是由他负责。
So many different devotees there, Lord Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya introduces them all one after another to Lord Chaitanya.
当时呢就是有很多这些奉献者，然后这个 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢就一个接一个逐一的把他们推荐给了主塔坦亚马哈帕布。
Lord Chaitanya hears how they're all meditating on the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya.
主塔坦亚马哈帕布就听到这个巴塔查亚说呢，所有的这些奉献者们都在不断的冥想他的莲花足。
And Lord Chaitanya embraced each and every one of them.
主塔坦亚就拥抱了他们每一个人。
And then.Bhavananda Roy came. Bhavananda Roy is the father of Ramananda Roy, and he came with his sons.
这个时候呢 ，Bhavananda Roy 来了，他带着他的四个儿子来到了现场。这个 Bhavananda Roy 是 Ramananda Roy 的父亲。
Ramananda Roy is the oldest son. Bhavananda Roy has five sons.And Ramananda Roy is the oldest, but Ramananda Roy is not there because he's not come yet. He's still in South India.
这个 Bhavananda Roy 呢有五个儿子，其中 Ramananda Roy 呢是他的长子，但是 Ramananda Roy 当时并不在现场，因为他当时还在南印度。
So Lord Chaitanya embraces him and he speaks about.Ramananda Roy, praises Ramananda Roy, you have such a nice son, he's so wonderful.
主塔坦亚呢就拥抱了巴瓦兰达洛伊，并且呢赞美了他的儿子 Ramananda Roy. 他就说到呢，你有这样的一个好儿子，真是太幸运了。
He said, you are like Maharaj Pandu himself. Maharaj Pandu also had five sons, his wife was Kunti.So you're like Maharaj Pandu, and your sons are like the five Pandavas.
主塔坦亚马哈帕布就说到呢，您就好比是Maharaj Pandu 本人，因为这个 Maharaj Pandu 有五个儿子，您也有五个儿子。而您的妻子呢，就好像是这个 Kunti Devi， 而您的这个五个儿子呢，就好比是五个 Pandava 兄弟。
But.Bhavananda Roy said, no, I said, I'm very fallen. I'm very low. I'm fourth class. I'm very fallen. But you touch me, so you're very, very kind. You are God himself.
但是这个 Bhavananda Roy 说到呢，我非常非常的堕落。我属于这个社会阶层的第四个等级，我是非常堕落的。 但是呢，您却触碰了我，这证明您非常的仁慈，您就是至尊人格守神。
He said, I've come to surrender everything at your lotus feet.
他说到呢，我来到这里就是要把我所有的一切都臣服在您的莲花足下。
And he said, I brought you one of my sons. This is one of my sons, Vaninath, and he will serve you. He will stay with you, and he will always be your whatever you want. He will do whatever you say. He's ready to be your servant and carry out all your instructions.
这个巴布拉纳诺也就说到呢，我的这个儿子名叫 Vaninath， 我把这个儿子呢留在您的莲花足下，以便一直。留意您的训示来服务您，不论你想要他做什么，你就去下达命令，让他来服务于您。
So Lord Chaitanya tells the man, he said, birth after birth you have been my servant, along with all your family members. Birth after birth you've been my servants.
主查泰马哈帕布就对巴布兰南洛伊说道，您和您的家庭成员一世不一世都是我的仆人。
So、you're not outsiders. You've been my servants all along.
他说到，您不是一个外人，您一世不一世都是我的仆人。
In a few days, Ramananda Rai is coming, and I will take great pleasure to be in his company again.
几天之后。巴布拉纳洛伊就会到来，我非常乐于享有他的陪伴。
So this boy Vaninath became his personal servant.
就这样，这个名叫 Vaninath 的这个男孩就成为了主柴坦卡的仆人。
Then they told everybody to go now. They let everybody go.And after everybody gone, then Lord Chaitanya called for his servant, Kala Krishna Das.
然后呢，主查泰亚马哈布就让所有的人离开了。当所有人离开之后呢，他叫来了他的仆人 Kala Krishna Das.
So Lord Chaitanya reported what happened while they were in South India.
主查泰亚就提到了当他在南印度旅行的时候所发生的事情。
He said, you know, you sent this man with me to go to South India. But you know what happened when we were in South India?
主就说到呢，你们要我把这个人带着和我一起旅行，但是你知道我们在南印度旅行的时候发生了什么事吗？
He left me. He gave up my association and he went off with the Bataharis. And I had to rescue him.
他说到呢，这个昆沙大使他离开了我的联谊，去和巴塔塔瑞们去联谊，而我不得不把他从他们的这个联谊当中拯救出来。
I had to rescue him and bring him here. Otherwise, he may not have. I don't know what would have happened if I had not rescued him.
这个呢，我把他拯救了出来，并且呢，把他带到了这里。我甚至不知道，如果我不去拯救他的话，会发生什么事。
But now that I brought him here, I don't want him with me. He can go wherever he likes.But I'm not going to be responsible for him anymore.
但是现在呢，我已经把他带回到这里了。我现在要他离开。现在他喜欢去哪里就去哪里，因为我不用再为他负责了。
So you see how strong Maya is? That even if you're the personal servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can fall into Maya. You can be attracted by women.
所以我们看到这个玛雅是如此的强大，即便这个有主查泰亚马哈帕布的联谊，但是呢还是有可能会堕入到这个玛雅的陷阱当中，受到女人等等的吸引。
These Bataharis were all degraded people, sinful people attached to money and sense gratification, cheating people.
这些巴塔塔人们呢都是非常堕落的人，他们都是追逐金钱还有感官享乐的人，欺骗别人。
And they had these women with them, although they dressed like sannyasis, the Bhattaharis dressed like sannyasis, they had women with them.
虽然这些 Bhattahari 们他们的穿着打扮跟 sannyasi 一样，但是呢他们却这个在和女人联谊。
And they used the women to attract more innocent men to come to them.
而且他们也在利用那些美丽的女子，去引诱那些年轻的男人加入他们。
So Lord Chaitanya saved Kala Krishna Das from these people.
所以主采塔亚玛哈帕布就将这个 Krishna Das 从这些人的手中，把他救了出来。
But now he said, I don't want him anymore. I can't be responsible. That he has to go now.
但是他说到呢，现在我不再为他负责了，他现在可以离开。
So when Lord Chaitanya rejected him, Kala Krishna Das began to cry.
当这个 Krishna Das 听说这个主 Chaitanya 拒绝他的时候呢，他就开始哭了。
But Lord Chaitanya didn't worry about him. Lord Chaitanya just left the room. He went to take his lunch.
但是主查坦亚马哈帕布并不在乎他，主查坦亚只是起身然后去吃午饭。
We saw in Prabhupada's time, sometimes Prabhupada would have servants and they would be cooking and traveling with Prabhupada, and often they would also have similar problems. They would get attracted to some woman.
我们知道在这个 Srila Prabhupada 的这个年代呢，有的时候有一些仆人会和这个 Srila Prabhupada 一起旅行，为他做一些服务，比如说烹饪什么的，但是呢他的这些仆人有时候也会受到女人的吸引。
And then they would give up the service, they would give up serving Prabhupada to go and serve some woman.
然后呢这些仆人都会放弃对 Srila Prabhupada 的服务，转而去服务那些女人。
So Lord Chaitanya could be like a thunderbolt. He could be very hard. Sometimes he could be very soft, but sometimes he could be very hard.
Lord Chaitanya 有的时候会像霹雳一样的坚硬，他有的时候会像玫瑰一样的柔软，但是有的时候他会像霹雳一样的坚硬。
So Lord Chaitanya rejected this Krishna Das, but the other devotees, Lord Nityananda and the other devotees,they had a plan for him.
So, the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected Krishna Das, but the other devotees, Nityananda Prabhu, had some plans.
And they told the plan. They said, "We need a person to go back to Bengal, to go to Mayapur and tell Sachimata about Lord Chaitanya, that Lord Chaitanya has come back to Jagannath Puri.Somebody has to go there and tell her."
然后尼加南达帕布呢，还有其他的这些奉献者们呢，就提议说，我们要找一个人去孟加拉，去告诉萨奇母亲有关于查泰马帕布抵达加格纳普里的消息。我们得派一个人去这个转达这个消息。
And when Advaita Acharya and Srivas, when they hear that Lord Chaitanya has come back to Puri, they will also want to come. So somebody should go and tell them.
当 Srivas, 等奉献者们听说主查塔亚玛哈帕布抵达的消息的时候呢，他们肯定会非常高兴，一定会来见他的。所以我们得派一个人去告诉他们，通知他们这个消息。
So in this way, they gave Krishna Das a nice service, and they sent him to Bengal to take the news of Lord Chaitanya.
So they, 就给这个 Krishna Das 找了一个很好的服务。他们把这个 Krishna Das, 派到了孟加拉去告诉奉献者们主有关主 Chaitanya 的消息。
So they told Lord Chaitanya, "We need permission to send someone to Bengal."To tell the devotees that you're back from South India.
所有的奉献者们呢，就问查塔亚马哈帕布，就请允许，我们派一个人去孟加拉，就是向奉献者们通知这个，主已经从南印度旅行回来的这个消息。
So Lord Chaitanya said, okay, do it, whatever you like, do it. So they sent Kala Krishna Das. He went to Bengal and he gave him a lot of Jagannath Prasadam to take back to Mayapur to distribute to all the devotees there.
主查拉马哈帕布就说呢，无论你们做什么的决定都可以。就这样呢，这个 Kala Krishna Das 就被派到了孟加拉，而且呢，他也带了很多主加干纳的这个食物的鲫鱼，派发给 Mayapur 的那些奉献者们。
He first went to Mother Sachi and he told Mother Sachi all the news, and then he went to Srivas and then to Advaita, and told everyone.
他先是去到了这个沙琪妈妈的家里，把这个消息告诉给了沙琪妈妈，然后他又去了 Srivas 的家里和 Advaita 的家里，他把这个消息告诉了所有的奉献者们。
So when they heard Lord Chaitanya come back to Jagannath Puri, then they all made a plan that, well, we're going to go to Jagannath Puri, let's go and we'll meet Lord Chaitanya.
当奉献者们听说这个主查塔亚马哈帕布已经回到加格纳布瑞的时候呢，他们都非常的高兴，他们就做出计划，要前往这个加格纳布瑞去见主查塔亚。
Many devotees, they had a big, everybody was registering, everybody said, I want to go, I will go, I will go. There were many devotees all decided to go, they all come to Jagannath Puri and will be with Lord Chaitanya.
所有的这些奉献者们，他们就都报名，我要去，我要去，所以呢，所有的这些奉献者们呢，就，都准备去这个加格纳普瑞，去和主查坦亚马哈帕布在一起。
So then, when Advaita Acharya got the news.He had a festival. He said, let's have a festival here for 2 or 3 days. They had a festival at Shantipur. And devotees all came. They had a big festival, chanting and dancing and prasadam.
当Advaita Acharya 听说这消息的时候呢，他就决定举行一个这个节日来庆祝。他就举行了这个2到3天的节日在 Shantipur。他的这个家里，然后奉献者们呢就都来到了山地坡，一起唱诵跳舞，来这个庆祝这个节日。
Then they came to get Mother Sachi's permission, and then they left from Navadvip to go to Puri.
然后呢，他们就这个经过这个沙琪玛塔的这个允许之后呢，他们就都来到了这个。
Yeah, and so a big group of devotees, and they got also some other, they got also Paramananda Puri. Paramananda Puri was a sannyasi who was traveling, and he also came. He also wanted to go to Jagannath Puri. He came with them.
所有的这些奉献者们呢，都聚集在了一起，在这个 Navadvip。当时呢，这个 Paramananda Puri 这位奉献者呢也在场。Paramananda Puri 呢，他是一名 sannyasi， 但是他也决定去 Jagannath Puri 去见主。
So when Paramananda Puri came there, Lord Chaitanya was very happy because he's a sannyasi and he's very senior. He's a disciple of Madhavendra Puri.
当 Paramananda Puri 到达这个 Jagannath Puri 的时候呢，这个主查坦亚感到非常的高兴，因为 Paramananda Puri 他是一位 sannyasi， 而且呢他是非常资深的，他是 Madhavendra Puri 的一名门徒。
So Lord Chaitanya enjoys the association with the senior devotees, sannyasis.
主呢就主塔塔马哈帕布就非常 享受与这些非常支撑的这个 Sanyasi 奉献者的联谊。
So they had another room at Kasimishra's house, and they put Paramananda Puri there, and they gave him also a servant.
所以呢，他就为这个 Paramananda Puri 在 Kasimishra 的家中安排了一个房间，并且给他安排了一名仆人。
Then Swarup Damodar arrived, and he was a very intimate friend of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from Mayapur.
这个时候呢 ，Swarup Damodar 也到达了。Swarup Damodar 是主查塔马帕布在 Mayapur 的一位非常亲密的朋友。
Swarup Damodar had originally he'd been staying in Navadvip with Lord Chaitanya. At that time, his name was Purushottam Acharya.
Swarup Damodar 曾经在这个 Navadvip 的 Mayapur 和主禅奈马帕布在一起有一段时间。之前他的名字叫 Purushottam Acharya。
So when he heard about Lord Chaitanya taking sannyas, he went to Varanasi to take sannyas.
当 Swarup Damodar 他听说主塔泰马帕布当了 sannyasi 之后，他也去 Varanasi 接受了这个 sannyasi。
And his spiritual master told him, the person who he was taking sannyas from, he told him, read the Vedanta Sutra and teach it to others.
这个给予他萨尼亚西启迪的这个姑乳呢，就告诉他要阅读维丹塔书所，并且把维丹塔书所教授给每个人。
So Swarup Damodar was he was very renowned and he was very scholarly.
Swarup Damodar 他非常的气绝，而且非常的有学识。
So he had taken full shelter of Lord Krishna.
他全心全意地托庇于至尊主 Krishna.
He was very enthusiastic to worship Krishna.
而且他非常热情地崇拜主 Krishna.
But he'd taken sannyas very quickly. He'd done it in a very almost like mad way. He did it, you know, very suddenly.
但是呢，他是非常快的接受了这个萨尼亚西进阶，近乎一种疯狂的方式，就是他是很突然的去当这个萨尼亚西。
So he gave up his sika and he gave up his sacred thread, but he didn't take the saffron cloth. He didn't take the saffron dress of the sannyasi.
他放弃了他的西卡和圣线。但是呢，他没有接受这个 sannyasi 的衣服。
And he didn't take the sannyasi danda.
他也没有接受这个 sannyasi danda 棍。
So he didn't take the sannyasi name either. He just kept the brahmachari name.
他甚至没有获得一个 sannyasi 的这个头衔，他只是保持了他的这个 brahmachari 的名字。
And then he took permission from his sannyasi guru that he could go to Jagannath Puri.
然后呢，他获得了他的这个 sannyasi guru 的许可。之后呢，他去了 Jagannath Puri.
And he could take shelter of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Jagannath Puri.
这样的话，他就可以在 Jagannath Puri 托庇于主查泰亚马哈帕布的莲花族。
This Swarup Damodar is one of the very intimate friends. In Krishna Lila, Swarup Damodar is a gopi Lalita.
Swarup Damodar, 他是主查泰马帕布一个非常亲密的朋友。在 Krishna 的逍遥时光当中 ，Swarup Damodar 是gopi Lalita。
Do you remember who is Ramananda Rai in Krishna Lila?
大家还记得这个 Ramananda Rai 在 Krishna 的逍遥时光当中是谁吗
？Listen.
是美沙拉。
Yeah, Vishakha. Yes, right, Vishakha. So Swarup Damodar, he is Lalita.
Swarup Damodar is Lalita.
Lalita is a bit older than Radharani. But Vishakha is the same age as Radharani. So Vishakha and Radharani, they have more friendship. Lalita is a bit more controlling.
So, 维沙卡呢, 和 Radharani 之间就有着更多的友谊, 而 Nanita呢, 他是比较更主导的, 他是去控制的。
So Swarup Damodar, he was very scholarly, and he did not spend time talking with people. He didn't waste time in nonsense talk. He was always engaged in a quiet place, and he was doing his sadhana and bhajan, and he didn't spend much time to talk with other people.
这个Swarup Damodar呢，他的学识非常的渊博，而且呢，他不喜欢和别人聊天，因为他不想浪费时间去说那些无聊的话语，所以呢，他总是。 待在一个僻静的地方，他不怎么和其他的人聊天。
But he was very well aware with all the knowledge about Krishna and the mellow, the dealings of rasa and the different etiquette in explaining about Krishna. He knew everything.
这个Swarup Damodar呢，他总是就是在僻静的地方去重置他的八藏，而且呢，他非常的这个通晓和 Krishna 有关的这些 rasa 这些超然的这些主旨。So
if someone would write a book, sometimes people would come to Jagannath Puri and they say, I've written a book, or I've written a play, I want to read it to Lord Chaitanya. I've written some poem about Lord Krishna or about Jagannath, I want to read it to Lord Chaitanya. Before they could read it, Swarup Damodar would first of all hear it. And he had to pass it, he had to say, yes, it's all right. If he did not agree, then they could not read it to Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，有一些人呢，他们会创作一些书籍或者是一些诗歌曲，他们呢就想把这些书籍还有诗歌朗读给主查泰亚马哈帕布听，但是呢，在他们朗诵之前呢，都会经过Swarup Damodar的检查，就是要经过他同意之后。
他们才可以在主查亚马哈帕布面前去朗读他们的这些诗歌。如果他不同意的话，那他们就不能够朗读。If they wrote something or said something which is wrong or which was not proper, Lord Chaitanya would get very upset. So therefore, before Lord Chaitanya would hear it, first of all, Swarup Damodar would hear it, and he had to pass it. Only then Lord Chaitanya would hear.
因为呢，如果他们的写作当中如果有错误的地方，或者是不恰当的地方的话，主查泰亚马哈帕布听了就会非常的失望。所以呢，在他们给主查泰亚马哈帕布朗读之前呢，都会经过斯瓦鲁达曼达尔的检查，就是他检查之后觉得合适了，才可以去朗读。Swarup
Damodar was not only expert in the philosophy and the knowledge of the scriptures, but he was also a very expert musician, and he could sing very wonderfully.
Swarup Damodar, 他不仅精通这个哲学，他不仅拥有这个有关于 Krishna 的知识，而且呢，他还是一位非常优秀的这个音乐家，他能够唱很好听的这个歌曲。So
Swarup Damodar would read to Lord Chaitanya. And he would read about books by the great Vaishnavas like Jayadev Goswami, who wrote the book, the Gita Govinda, he would read to Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya liked it very much.
对呢，说若他们大尔就经常会给主查亚玛帕布朗读一些伟大奉献者所写的这些诗歌，比如说加耶德瓦戈斯瓦米的所著的这些诗歌，这个说若他们大尔呢就会唱给主查亚玛帕布听，主查亚玛帕布就非常喜欢他的这个唱的歌。
He would also read poems by two poets. There was one poet Vidyapati and another poet.Chandidas. So Swarup Damodar would read their poems to Lord Chaitanya also. So as a musician, Swarup Damodar was like a Gandharva, very expert in singing and music, everything.
作为一位音乐家呢，这个 Swarup Damodar 就像 Gandharva 这些歌仙一样，他非常的擅长这个唱歌和跳舞。
And in discussing the scriptures, philosophical discussion, he was like Brihaspati.The guru of the demigods.
而在这个哲学的讨论上呢，他就好像是天堂们的这个半神人的老师 Brihaspati.
So there was nobody really to compare to him. He was very, very great devotee.
所以说 Swarup Damodar 是一位非常伟大的奉献者，没有人能和他相比。
He was very dear to Advaita Acharya and Lord Nityananda and all the devotees and Srivas, everyone loved him. When he came to Jagannath Puri and met Lord Chaitanya, he fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya and offered his obeisances to Lord Chaitanya.
当斯瓦若布达玛达尔来到加德纳普里见主查泰亚玛阿帕布的时候，他向主查泰亚玛阿帕布致以五体投地的礼拜。
Lord Chaitanya was very happy to see him again, to have him back in their association.
主查泰亚玛阿帕布非常高兴再次得到他的联谊，再次把他带到这里来。
Lord Chaitanya said, I've been like a blind man without you, but now you've come, my vision has come again.
主查亚玛阿帕布说到呢，没有你的联谊，我就像一个瞎子。然而呢，你的到来使我重新恢复了视力。
And Swarup Damodar said, I'm very sorry, I made a mistake, I shouldn't have left you, I shouldn't have went to Varanasi.I should never have left you.
说肉达玛达尔就说到呢，我的主，我不应该放弃你的这个陪伴去 Varanasi。
But he said somehow you've brought me back. He said you've brought me back to your lotus feet.
但无论如何呢，您又把我带回到了您的这个莲谊当中，把我带到了您的莲花足下。
And then Swarup Damodar also worshipped Lord Nityananda and got blessings from Lord Nityananda.
Swarup Damodar 也崇拜了主 Nityananda, 得到了主 Nityananda 的这个祝福。
So Swarup Damodar was given a nice quiet place where he could stay, and he was also given a servant to.Take care of him.
So, this Swarup Damodar also got a good place to live, and he also got a servant to take care of him.
So then, the next person to come to join them in Jagannath Puri was a person called Govinda, who was a disciple of Ishwara Puri.
然后呢又来了一名奉献者来到加德纳普瑞来加入到主查泰亚马哈帕布。这位奉献者的名字叫 Govinda， 他是伊斯瓦普瑞的一个门徒。
So Govinda told him, he introduced himself, he said, I am a servant of Ishwarapuri, my name is Govinda, and my guru has ordered me to come here.
这个名叫 Govinda 的这个奉献者呢，他就介绍自己说，我是 Ishwarapuri 的仆人，我的名字是 Govinda， 我的灵性导师训斥我来到这里。
Just before my guru left the world, he told me, he said, you go to Lord Chaitanya and give service to him, serve him there.
在我的灵性导师离开这个物质世界之前，他命令我说，我应该去找主查坦亚马哈帕布，并且为他服务。
And he said, another devotee is also coming, Kashishwara. He's also a disciple of Ishwarapuri, and he's also coming.But he's gone to visit the holy places first. He'll be coming after some time.
他还说到呢，一位名叫卡西斯瓦拉的奉献者也会来到这里。他也是伊斯瓦布瑞的一名门徒。他现在在圣地旅行，但是一段时间之后，他也会来到这里。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "My guru is like my father. He's always taking care of me."So it's very kind that he has sent you here.
主查达亚马哈帕布就说到呢，我的灵性导师伊斯瓦普瑞就像父亲一样关怀着我，因为他无怨的仁慈，所以他派你到这里来。
But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya has a doubt. He said, why did Ishwarapuri have a servant who comes from a sutra family?
这个时候，沙瓦宝马巴塔查亚心里有一个疑惑，他就问道：“伊斯瓦普瑞为什么会留下一个来自苏卓家庭的仆人
？”Yeah, Govinda was just from a sudra family, but he was the personal servant of Ishwara. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is surprised. He said, "You know, guru is supposed to have Brahman as a servant. The Brahman is supposed to serve the guru."
因为这个 Govinda 呢，他是来自于苏卓的家庭，然而呢，他却是伊斯瓦普瑞的这个贴身的仆人，所以说沙巴巴马巴塔查亚就感到很惊讶，因为这个萨那吉布鲁本来应该由一个布拉玛那的仆人来服务于他，而这个伊斯瓦普瑞为什么却留下 Govinda 这样一个来自于苏卓家庭的仆人呢？
So Lord Chaitanya explains, he said, Krishna and the Guru are both independent. Krishna and the Guru are not required to follow the Vedic rules and regulations. They are transcendental.
Krishna 和 Guru 灵性导师都不受制于任何伟大规范和原则，他们都是超然的。
Anybody who takes initiation from the spiritual master, then they come to the transcendental platform.
任何得到了 Guru 灵性导师启迪的人，也会来到超然的层面。
Mercy of Krishna doesn't depend on your birth.
主 Krishna 的仁慈并不取决于一个人的出身。
Vidura was a sudra, but Krishna took lunch at the home of Vidura.
Vidura 虽然是一名出者，然而主 Krishna 却在他的家里，进食午餐。
Because Vidura's by birth he may be a sudra, but he's a great devotee.
因为维多拉他的出生可能是一名出者，然而他却是一名伟大的奉献者。
Who is Vidura? What's his usual position before he came into the Krishna pastime? What was he doing?
这个维多拉是谁？在这个维多拉加入到主 Krishna 的逍遥时光之前，他在做什么
？Anybody know?
他是阿尔朱纳的叔叔，他在他在参与这个消消时光之前，他是阎罗王，就是
Yes.
阎罗王，他的前身是释迦牟尼王。
Very good. 你是谁？
我是 Radha Priya 这位大姐。
哦，你是 Radha Priya， 我听不认识你的声音。Yes, Radha Priya is right. Very good. This is Yalawa. So, Vidura is, but he taken birth as a Sudra, but he got Krishna to come there and eat his meal.
所以呢，这个 Vidura 他出生为一名书生，然而呢，他却邀请这个主 Krishna 在他的家中接受午饭。
So Krishna is controlled by love. Love is more important to Krishna.
所以主 Krishna 是受到爱的控制，这个爱心，对于 Krishna 而言是更重要的。
Wherever there's pure love and devotion, then Krishna is attracted to go there.
无论哪里有爱心和这个奉献服务，无论哪里有爱和奉献，主 Krishna 就会受到吸引，就会去到那里。
So, Lord Chaitanya is happy to see Govinda.But he has a question. He said, Govinda is my god brother, and he's coming here to be my servant. Is this proper?
这个主查坎雅呢，他非常高兴见到古文达，但是呢，他有一个问题。他就说到呢，这个 Govinda 是我的宁静兄弟，然而现在他却要成为我的仆人，那这合适吗？
He was the servant of my guru, and I'm also my guru's servant. So we're god brothers.
他是我的 guru, 我的宁静导师的仆人，而我也是我的宁静导师的仆人，所以说我们是宁静兄弟。那他现在要来服务我，就合适吗？
Yeah, should I? He wants to be my personal servant.
他要成为我的这个亲生的仆人。
My spiritual master gave him the order that he should come and serve me. What should I do?
这个我的灵性导师就命令他，要他来这里服务于我，我应该怎么办呢？
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya says, the order of the spiritual master cannot be disobeyed.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就说到，宁静导师的训斥不能够去违背。
It's the life and soul of the disciple.
宁静导师的训斥是门徒的这个生命和灵魂。
And he gives an example. He said, just like Parasuram killed his mother because he was ordered by his father.
他就举了一个例子，他就说到这个 Parasurama， 他因为接受他父亲的命令，杀死了他的母亲。
Yeah, there's a story that the mother of Parasurama, Renuka, that she was getting water one day.And when she was taking water, she happened to see there was some demigod looking at her. Because she was a good-looking, very attractive woman. So demigod came to and was looking at her. And she saw the demigod, and she saw this demigod. Oh, he's a very handsome man, very handsome demigod.
这里呢，其中有一个故事。就讲的是 Parasurama 的母亲，Renuka。这个 Renuka 她有一次在喝水的时候呢，就有一个半神人在看着她，因为这个 Renuka 她是一个非常美丽的女子，所以这个就吸引了这个半神人去注视她。这个 Renuka 呢也注意到一个非常英俊的这个男人在看着她。
So then, the husband. somehow the husband knew about this, and he was very upset. So he had four sons. So he told his oldest son, "Your mother has been unfaithful, kill her."
所以呢，这个人努卡的这个丈夫听说了这个事情之后呢，他非常的失望，因为他有四个儿子，所以他就命令他的最年长的这个儿子帕拉苏拉玛去杀死他的母亲。
He wouldn't do it. So then he asked the second son and the third son, they wouldn't do it. But then when he asked Parasaram, the youngest son, Parasaram killed the mother, cut off her head. And then the father said, and you can kill your brothers also because they disobeyed my order. So Parasaram cut off their heads.
他就坚持要他的这个最年长的这个儿子去杀死他，但是这个最年长的儿子并没有服从他的命令，然后呢，他就要他的第二个儿子去杀死他的母亲，但是第二个儿子也没有服从，所以最后呢，他的这个父亲就要阿拉苏拉玛去杀死他的这个母亲仁努卡，而且他也说呢，你也可以去杀掉你的这些长兄，因为你的这些长兄没有服从我的命令。
So father was very pleased with Parasaram. He said, "Very good, you're a very good son. You can ask from me any benedictions you want."
于是呢，这个阿拉苏拉玛就杀掉了他的母亲，然后他的父亲呢就感到非常的高兴，他就说：“你可以向我索要任何一个你想要的祝福。”
So he said, "Okay." He said, "I want the blessings that my mother and brothers will come back to life, and I want them blessing that they don't know anything about what happened."
然后这个帕拉苏拉玛就回答说呢，我要一个祝福，就是我的母亲和我的这些兄长们都重新获得这个重新又活过来，而且呢，他们会不记得所有发生过的事情。
So father suggests, "Very good, let it be."
所以这个他的父亲就说到呢，很好，那就这样吧。
So this is a famous example that how we should follow the order. You're given an order by the father or a spiritual master, you should follow it.
所以呢，这就是这个萨瓦巴玛巴塔恰雅在这里举的一个例子，就说明了。 我们要去服从父亲，以及宁静导致的命令。
So the same way Lakshman followed the order of Lord Ramachandra, his older brother.
同样的 Lakshma 也服从他的兄长主 Ramachandra 的命令。
So we take the order of the spiritual master without being without considering is it right or is it wrong, you just follow the order of the spiritual master.
所以呢，我们要服从灵性导致的命令，不去考虑这个命令是正确的还是错误的。我们必须要这个不加考虑的去服从灵性导致的命令。
So after Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said this, Lord Chaitanya was very happy and he embraced Govinda, and Govinda became his personal servant.
萨瓦邦玛巴塔恰雅说完这番话之后呢，主查坦雅就变得高兴起来，并且拥抱了古文达。就这样呢，古文达成了他的贴身的仆人。Everyone
loved Govinda as the servant of Lord Chaitanya. He was very dear, loved by all the devotees.
每个人都非常爱古文达，因为这个古文达是查坦雅马哈普的贴身的仆人。
He served all the needs of the devotees, not only Lord Chaitanya, he would serve all the Vaishnavas.
而古文达呢，也会服务于所有的Vaishnava，不仅仅是查坦雅，他也会服务所有的Vaishnava们。Okay,
so we will stop here. I think it's a good place to stop, and we can continue tomorrow.
今天我们就讲到这里，明天我们再继续。Are
there any question?
看看大家有没有问题。
Anybody?
There is one question. Krishna Balarama Das 明白 Guru Maharaja 主查泰亚马帕布拒绝与国王联谊，是因为他是物质主义者吗？跟物质主义者联谊有哪些坏处？如何拒绝与物质主义者的联谊？ The question is from Krishna Balarama Das. Obeisances to Guru Maharaj. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected the association with the king. It's because he is the materialistic person.
Yes.
What is the bad influence to associate with materialistic person? How to reject this kind of association?
Yes, the king is a materialistic person because a king's business, a king, you know, he enjoys a lot of sense gratification. He's given a lot of luxury and he enjoys a lot of comfort and service.
这个国王是一位物质主义者，因为呢，他有很多的感官享乐，他得到这种很奢侈的这个便利设施，他得到很多的服务。
King has a lot of wealth, you know, he will have a treasury, he will have a lot of wealth, and because he has a lot of wealth, there will be a lot of women there, and, you know, there will be a lot of opportunity for sense gratification.
国王呢拥有很多的财富，拥有很多的珠宝，而且呢，他也拥有很多的女人。这样的话，他就有很多的机会进行感官享乐。
So where one is very much concerned with wealth and the opposite sex, then it's very difficult to remember Krishna.
哪里有这些这些财富和女人的话，就很难得到就很难记起这个 Krishna。
Just like in the Srimad Bhagavatam, the personality of Kali was told he could stay wherever there is hoarding of gold, because where there is hoarding of gold, then the other sinful activities will come.
就好像在这个正典博迦瓦坛当中，这个卡里年代的这个人格化身被告知，他可以留在这个黄金当中。
And so brahmanas are traditionally kept poor. They don't get a lot of wealth, and it's good for them because they don't get so much disturbed by desire for sense gratification.
传统上呢，这些 brahmana 婆罗门呢都是很贫穷的，而且这对他们来说呢，反而是一件好事。他们没有很多的这些财富，这样的话，他们不会受到这种感官享乐的这种打扰。
Okay. Does that answer the question?
He is asking that how to reject this kind of association.
How to reject it? Well, you have to take association with devotees, associate with the devotees.
那如何拒绝与物质主义者的联谊呢？你就要去和奉献者联谊。
You need association, so associate with the devotee, and that way you don't need to associate with the materialists.
你要去和奉献者联谊，这样的话你就不用和那些物质主义者联谊。
Of course, this king of Puri, he was actually a devotee, but still Lord Chaitanya was setting an example for others by refusing to associate with him.
当然了，这个普里的这个国王呢，他是一名奉献者，但是呢，主查泰亚马法布是为了树立一个榜样，就是作为一个萨尼亚西，他不去和这个物质主义者的这个国王联谊。
And later on, Lord Chaitanya allowed the king to come, but the king had to disguise himself.We'll hear more about how Lord Chaitanya dealt with the king. There's more involved.
当然了，这个后来呢，主财参呢，马哈帕布同意接见这个国王，但是呢，这个国王是乔装打扮了的， 当然这个逍遥直观我们会在之后聆听的。
Any other question?
Yes, 郑敏问，要去服从灵性导师的命令，不去考虑是正确的还是错误的，这得是完全臣服的奉献者吧？如何培养这种信心？Zhiming is asking that we have to follow the order of spiritual master, not consider is right or wrong. So it must be a devotee who completely surrender. How can we develop this faith?
Well, by cultivating more knowledge and by practice of devotional service and through association and seeing the practical example of the spiritual master and developing more trust and confidence in the instruction of the spiritual master, then we will want to follow.
首先呢，你要培养这些知识，而且呢，你要做奉献服务。然后呢，你要去和这个灵性导师联谊，然后在这个聆听他的训示，然后从而呢获得更多的这个信任，和信心。
So it takes time. You have to be patient. We cannot be mad. We have to take it step by step and gradually cultivate your faith.
所以呢，这个是需要时间的，你需要一些耐心，就是这个是逐步的过程来培养这个信心。
Good questions, very nice questions from the devotees, very good.
这对于奉献者们来说是一个很好的问题。
Both questions today, both all the questions usually here are very good. The devotee questions which we get.From these classes, I'm very satisfied. Very good questions. Very, very intelligent questions.
在这些讲课当中，奉献者们提出来的这些问题都是非常好的问题，我感到很满意。这些问题都是非常好的，有帮助的。
Is there any other question today?
Yes.冒险王问：顶拜咕噜，请问主威士努与主达拉亚纳都是四臂形象，两者的区别是什么？冒险王 is asking that Lord Vishnu and Lord Narayana are all four arms form. What's the difference between them?
No difference.
他们两者没有区别。
Lord Vishnu is the Purusha avatar. He is doing the work of the creation. You know, he lies in the causal ocean, then he expands in the universes.
这个主 Vishnu 呢是 Purusha avatar. 你知道他是怎么这个扩展他自己，然后创造这个物质展示的吗？
And Lord Narayana is in the spiritual world in Vaikuntha.
而主 Narayana, 他是在灵性世界外昆塔。
Okay. Is there any other question?
No questions.
Okay, all right, so we will stop here today. So we thank all the devotees very much. Fechangganshiya, Tulsi Gopinath Maharaji, Gewam Jangtai Defani, Vamaganshiya Janaka, Jujur.感谢所有的奉献者聆听提问，我们明天见，明天最后一天啊 ，Hare Krishna， 释迦牟尼佛，
感恩
观世音
菩萨，
感恩观世音菩萨，
感恩咕噜，
感恩咕噜，
感恩咕噜 ，Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna, Guru, 准备您莲花指。
顶拜你的莲花指。顶拜
你的莲花
指。顶拜你的莲花
指。
Hare Krishna.